T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. All three engines up and burning. 2, 1, 0, and liftoff.
Coach on Fire Radio. Hey, oh my gosh, I love those tropical EDM vibes from my DJ and producer friend, Chico. Welcome, you guys. This is Brave Healing, Words That Change the World. I am Laura DeFranco, and my mission is to start a revolution of brave healers who are healing themselves and the world by sharing their stories. On this podcast, we're going to have the conversations you crave, the ones that create a ripple. And today, I am so grateful to tell you guys that this podcast, for the first time, is being sponsored by two amazing groups, The Wellness Universe. Please, you guys, go to www.thewellnessuniverse.com and check out all the incredible ways you can be supported on your wellness journey, both as a consumer or a health and wellness professional. Do you write? Make sure to join The Wellness Universe, and you can do that for free and start submitting your blogs. Out of the several platforms I've been a part of over the last few years, the Wellness Universe continues to stand out to me. The founders, Anna and Sherry, are the real deal, you guys. Heart-centered, authentic, badass. So you guys, check them out, thewellnessuniverse.com. And today's show is also being sponsored by Ginny Robertson, the founder of the On Purpose Woman Community. Ginny is another badass woman who's changing the world one connection at a time. She has local opportunities all over Maryland, as well as a global online platform where you can connect with other women and begin to build the community you need to thrive, whether you're retired, transitioning careers, looking for work, or looking to connect with prospective clients. You're going to want to hop over to JinnyRobertson.com or find the On Purpose Woman community on Facebook. So now I'm going to invite you all to take a deep breath with me and really arrive here in the moment today in your body. Let yourself feel the words today. Notice how a word or a tone or a topic feels inside of you. Feeling is healing. And today I am welcoming Honoré Corder, the author of the new book, Stop Trying So Fucking Hard. She is the author of dozens of books, you guys, including You Must Write a Book, the Prosperous Writer book series, the Like a Boss book series, Vision to Reality, Business Dating, the Successful Single Mom book series, If Divorce is a Game, These Are the Rules, and The Divorced Phoenix. OMG, you guys. She is also Hal Elrod's business partner in the Miracle Morning book series. If you guys haven't read any of the Miracle Morning books, you need to go run and do that now. And Honoré coaches business professionals, writers, and aspiring nonfiction authors who want to publish their books to bestseller status, create a platform, and develop multiple streams of income. She also does all sorts of other magical things, and her badassery is legendary. You can find out more at honorecorder.com. And I'm going to spell her name for you guys, H-O-N-O-R-E-E. CORDER.com. Okay. Find her after the show. Go look. And please make sure you guys go onto her free group on Facebook, the Prosperous Writers Mastermind. I'm in there. You're going to find me in there. You're not going to regret being a part of that community. So, Honoré, I am so happy you're here with me today. I have been following you for a long time. I have so many of your books, and every single time I read one of them, I get multiple nuggets that I've been able to use on my writing journey. And I'm pretty sure I was attracted to you right off the bat because you use words like badassery. I've enjoyed reading so many of your books, and I just wanted to mention that I was thrilled and honored to be an advanced reader of your new one. So tell me about it.
Oh gosh. So thank you for having me with you today and with your audience. It's an honor to be with you. I wrote Stop Trying So Fucking Hard because, as a lady of a certain age, I will be 50 in a couple of years. I watch people twist themselves into a pretzel and have for a really long time to try to present themselves to the world in a way that other people who are seemingly successful present themselves to the world, i.e., my life is perfect, so I'm going to take a selfie, right? And I'm going to use the right filter so I don't have any lines on my forehead, and I look skinny and rich and fabulous. And so there's a lot of that that goes on. And then if you're looking up to that person and you see that, you think, oh, I want to be like that too. And so what you're trying to be is something that's not real most of the time. And so people are trying to be something that may or may not truly exist because most people don't put their worst foot forward out into the world on social media, those types of things. And so I wrote the book just to kind of say, look, your authentic self, your real self is what people resonate with most. It's what's going to find, how people are going to find you. And resonate with you and be attracted to you, right? Being your authentic self is actually the easiest person you can be. But when you're trying to be someone you're not, it's exhausting.
It's
And then you're
so
also.
exhausting. It's so exhausting to do that every day. And there's a point where you're going to feel it inside of your body sooner or later. And I had a friend who said, you better smell the smoke before the house burns down. And so when you start to feel these little things inside of you, oh man, do not let your house burn down. Figure out who you are and who you're being and all the things you just talked about. It's exhausting. So anyway, I don't know you. I don't know why you
Unless
made
you're
me think of
attracting.
that.
Well, it's exhausting to be someone that you're not. And then you're also then attracting people who are attracted to that. So then they're not even the right people. So then you're attracting people that you have to keep being. I call it being the representative, right? You send the representative. They always say, like, you don't date the real person for the first 6 months because they're sending the representative. Like, you always see them dressed up and ready to go and at their best and not having any type of a problem. And then after 6 months, they're like, oh my gosh, this is too much to keep up. And then you start to see cracks in the armor. Then you see the person who's cranky or grouchy or abusive or whatever.
This is so perfect. I have written down here a quote from your book. It says, "What if, just for a moment, you told the representative to fuck off?" And actually, you say fuck right off and just started saying what you want to say, doing what you want to do, and going where you want to go. So tell me more about this representative and actually how to get over it.
Well, it's just that it's any part of you that is thinking, I have to be something that I'm actually not in order for someone to like me. If I tell someone that my marriage isn't fantastic, or that I'm in debt, or that I really didn't want to be a lawyer, or I really am gay and not straight, or I really am straight and not gay, right? Like, whoever you're sending out in the world that isn't your authentic self, that's you sending out the representative. And it's not just being pissy with people because you don't like people. You have to still have a sense of gentility of social graces, right? Like, that's, I'm not talking about just running around and being rude and punching people in the face when they upset you. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about who you're being in any given moment and just being who you are. And it's actually easier than people think to kind of just let their guard down. And I talk about my aha moments with that in the book. I talk about the first one where we all have that time when something happens that's a significant emotional event right before we're supposed to do something, an interview, a lunch meeting, go on stage. A coaching call, right? This is my life, right? A podcast interview, whatever. And there's something that happens the 5 minutes before. And I can give you an example of one that happened that is not in the book because I didn't write about it yet. If you'd like.
I would love it.
Sure. So 5 minutes before a 90-minute coaching session with one of my high-profile clients, the sheriff came and knocked on the door and said that someone had written a threat against my daughter's life in the bathroom of high school that mentioned Columbine.
Oh, my goodness.
And this was 3 weeks before her graduation. So here I am, like, preparing for the call, reviewing my notes, da-da-da-da-da, bang, 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 open the door. And it was like, oh, okay.
Wow.
Wow. How am I supposed to handle that? And I just authentically called my client and said, this is what's happening. I'll call you in about 15 or 30 minutes, if that's okay with you. And fortunately, it was someone I had a long-standing relationship with. So it was fine. But that's what I'm talking about. You have those significant emotional events that happen right before you're supposed to be your best self. Right?
Yes.
This is my best self, my most professional self. And then what do you do in that moment? And how do you recover in that moment? And so my first aha moment was something similar to that. Obviously not the same. Hopefully that doesn't happen twice to some one person. But I went to a meeting with someone, and when they asked me how I was, I just, like, the tears, like, were popping out of my face. Like, that, like, I was just in that moment overcome with my humanity and with the fact that I was having a tough time in my life at that moment. And rather than try to be, everything's fine, everything's hunky-dory, would you like, you know, two Splenda or three? I just said, you know what, I'm having a tough time. And the person across from me said, oh, thank God, I didn't know you were human.
Oh, mm-hmm.
I so relate to you so much more. Because I didn't imagine you had a bad day. Honoré doesn't have bad days. Of course not. Well, I beg to differ. I could name six or seven just right off the top of my head without even thinking hard about it. So that's the first thing, is I wrote the book because I saw people behaving that way. And then as their coach, they would then kind of let the wall down. Here I am, this world famous XYZ, but actually I'm ABC or JKL, but I'm too afraid to let the world know about that. And I would say, well, I love you so much more because you're this world famous thing and you have these struggles. You then become relatable to me. We all become relatable to each other through our stories and through our humanity. There is no such thing as a perfect anything, but yeah. you get closer, not to perfection, but to true authenticity and happiness when you just say, I'm going to be my authentic self. And the people who stay are meant to stay, and the people who go are meant to go.
Yeah, amen to that. Oh my goodness. You know, okay, so speaking of authenticity, I kind of thought it was funny that right in the beginning of the book, you apologized for your quote, saucy language. Mm-hmm. And I want to know why you decided to include the apology.
Because there are people who discount someone who uses saucy language. It's not appropriate. We're not supposed to do it, right? But it's like the coffee mug that says, you know, I love Jesus and I swear a little, right? It's like, yeah. I think there are very few people who don't on occasion use some strong language. And what I wanted people to do, and I actually have a very good friend of mine, I've known her for 30 years, and she said to me, I love you. I read all of your books. I don't swear. And swearing, she was in the military. So she said, swearing, I have a visceral reaction to swearing. Mm. And so I just can't do it. And I said, okay, I love you. And you know, I'll catch you on the flip side.
Yes.
There are more coming. There's more in the pipeline.
Yeah.
But I wanted someone to really, because there are several books with the F word in the title.
Yes.
And people have an expectation for that type of a book. I wasn't doing it because I wanted people to go, oh yeah, I totally resonate. I'm going to buy this. Right? There's Go the Fuck to Sleep and Get Over Your Damn Self. And
yeah.
There are books that people buy just because of that. And so I wanted people to be very clear that it was an attention-getting mechanism. My point was, how do I get your attention otherwise?
Mm-hmm.
If I used a softer title, then they might not be ready for the strong message of the book, which is to stop it already.
Mm-hmm.
Just stop it. Don't stop it tomorrow. Don't think about stopping it a month from now. Stop it. stop sending the representative, stop being your inauthentic self, be your authentic self. And that does not mean that you're imperfect. As a matter of fact, it allows you to be imperfect and still feel like you are enough